Hi, Pariniti. Welcome, welcome. It's such a pleasure to have you around.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Hi, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Is it on? Hello?
Yep, yep.
Hi, guys. Hi, hi, hi. Good evening, good evening, good evening. It is so nice to be here. Good? This good?
Can I use this?
Yep, yep. Thank you so, so much, first of all, for having me. I've been hearing about this for years, and I hear about these expos, and I always used to wonder what they were about, but we never had the chance to really have them in our own country, let alone our own city. So I'm really happy you all are here. I can't wait to walk around and do a little bit of shopping. But before that, we'll speak a lot about my love and your love, which is diving. And yeah, I'm really excited.
Just to know, since when have you been diving?
I actually had to shoot an underwater sequence for my film Kill Dil, and my diving guru, who is Anees Aidenwala, he's not yes. here. His wife is here somewhere, Sharmeen. She's here. Oh, there she is. So they are actually the reason I started to dive. They taught me in Mumbai, and then they took me all around the world. They arrange all my diving trips. So it's because of them that I really dive. But I started in 2013. 2014 is when I started. So 5 years. So I'm a baby, a new baby.
Well, I'm sure many like me may be present over there. Just to know, what do you like in particular about the sport?
What I like the most about diving, no phone network underwater. Nobody can call me. My manager cannot call me and tell me any work. Honestly, I used to hear a lot of these scuba divers who used to say, you know, it's like meditation. Some people say, you know, it's as good as a drug. Some people say, you know, it's the most peaceful thing. It always used to be theory for me. Sure. And then I remember my first time that I ever did a dive was in Bali. And I think that when I came out from my first dive, I think I was a changed person. I'm not a very sporty person. This was literally the only sport which was in my life. And I got addicted very quickly. And now I try at least to take 2 or 3 diving trips every year. And yeah, it's something that I cannot live without anymore.
I sum it up like a detox program for you.
I mean, it really is. Honestly, it is a detox program because I actually leave my phone behind. I've done land-based diving. I've done liveaboard diving. And I literally love to just forget about my phone. You know, that's the main thing. And I've made so many friends all over the world, you know, people who were on the boats with me or my instructors or the resorts that I've stayed in or, you know, the liveaboards. We meet so many new people.
Wow.
So I've made so many like friends all over the world now. So it's amazing.
When you say all around the world, where all around the world would you be diving?
I think I would say some of my favorites have been Sipadan. I loved Sipadan.
Okay.
I went there with Sharmeen and Anees, of course. I love the Maldives. It's one of my favorites because it's just so easy to get to.
Superb.
Yeah, I love the Maldives. I did my liveaboard also at Maldives, actually. I did the Great Barrier Reef in Australia, of course. Unfortunately, we must do something to make it better, but at least I can say I've dived there. What else?
Where else?
I've forgotten. Sharmeen? Oh, Palau, of course. How can I forget? I love, love, love Palau. Very exotic. Very few people get to actually go there in their lifetime. I've gone there twice because I loved it so, so much. So some of my favorites.
Any anecdotes on your diving experience? Any one in specific that would just cross your mind?
I think the experience that has stayed with me the most has been when I was in the Maldives with the whale sharks. Mm. And I think that was one of my favorite thing. And I also did a dive where I was at the cleaning station and I was with 14 mantas for 70 minutes. Wow. And it was my first Nitrox dive, so I did a really long dive. And even at the safety stop, I was just like surrounded by mantas, so I can never forget that experience. Maldives has actually given me a couple of good dives. And Palau.
Superb.
No, calm down. There are more locations also. Maldives are very happy. In Palau, this time I did, the Japanese wrecks, the World War II wrecks. I did an underwater chandelier cave. I did some crazy diving. It was amazing. I can like never stop talking. So you should interrupt me.
And what would you want to say about your association with ADEX India Mumbai Dive Show Ocean Festival?
It's even better than signing a film for me. I just think that this is an association that you know is not really. You know, usually actors take decisions according to what is good for their career and things that are good for their work, you know, things that add to their work life. But I think we somewhere forget what our passions are and we forget what we live for. Diving is truly one of those things that I live for today, you know, and to kind of make it official like this, to be the ambassador is something that I'm really proud of, honestly. And I told them that whenever they call me, I'll be here. Please keep calling me. Please don't forget about me after today and I'll be here because I really want to spread the word. I think we all should be divers. I think everybody needs to be a diver. Everybody needs to work for the oceans now. They need us more than ever. So yeah, I think this is a very important association and I hope that I can really make a difference.
We did get to know that you are like a fitness pro. Okay.
No. Yeah, abhi naya hua hai meri life mein.
But I just want to know how has diving enhanced your fitness goals?
Anybody who knows my story knows that I never used to be a fitness enthusiast ever. But now I'm doing a biopic on Saina Nehwal. So almost by force, I have to be very, very fit and I'm working on it. But I think diving, honestly, is one of the healthiest things you can do. It's one of the most disciplined ways of holidaying. That's what I always say. Like, you know, I love to wake up at 5 a.m. I love my 6 a.m. and 7 a.m. dives. I love the food that we eat. We always eat the freshest food. We're breathing the cleanest air. We're in the surrounding of, you know, beauty. We're meeting amazing people. It is truly one of the healthiest way to holiday, I believe. So, which is why I try and convince everybody. I've converted a lot of my friends into divers, proud to say. And I want to influence all of you. All of you should be divers.
And who in the diving world would you look out to for support, training, guidance?
There are, at the moment, two people who are very important, who are on my speed dial when I'm on my holidays. Sharmeen and Anees, of course, because they were the first ones who brought it into my life. So I will never forget where I started. Of course, she has a lovely team in her office. They're always there 24/7 to help us. So anything that happens, even if I get the slightest rash in the ocean, I immediately call them and say, see what has happened to me.
Way to go,
so yeah, they are my go-to people, for sure.
Any suggestions that how you can make India more aware about diving?
I've come now, today. Today onwards, now we'll make them more aware. No, I think we're all on the right track. You know, diving is, it's not a new sport. It's been there for years and years and years. But somehow, I think India is just about waking up to it a few years ago. I mean, the diving community is small and they are very regular. But I think it's not widespread yet. True. And I think we need to spread the word a little more. It needs to become as popular as cricket is, you know, I don't know. It should be something that is a part of everybody's life.
That definitely needs an applause, guys.
So yeah, so I'm here. I will do the work, don't worry.
Indians getting aware on the same. Last but not the least, any injuries or challenges while you were diving or while you learned?
No, I've been trained by the best.
Oh, way to go again.
So no, of course, safety is one of the most important things while you're diving. And any instructor, that's the beauty of it. Anywhere in the world that I've gone to some not so great places, I've gone to some great places, I've gone with some amazing schools, I've gone with some not so amazing schools, but the one thing that they take care of is diver safety. No matter what, it is non-negotiable, your life is non-negotiable, and that makes me, I feel so safe. I feel so much more confident because I don't think I'm a very, very adventurous person. So it's perfect for a person like me because I feel so much at peace.
I mean, getting in the water and that deep. So
oh, yeah. To be I mean, I love the water, but it's still underwater. So
it has really been amazing to know
Thank
so
you.
Much, Parineeti. I don't.
Thank
I mean, none of us would know so much in detailing, right?
No, they all are pros. They all know everything.
All right. So now for the question, guys, we would request you to please stick to the diving and her experience in relation to the divings. Yes? Any questions?
Yes, ma'am. Zor se bolo. I'll hear you.
Hello.
Yes.
Sorry. Yeah. Pariniti, what's the message to the youth as founder of Young Environmentalist Program? I feel that, what's your message to the youth to attract them to such an adventurous sport, especially where mental health is a problem and where more adventure and more wellness. So what's your message to the youth to get them to dive?
At the risk of sounding morbid, I think it is more important for the youth to take care of our planet, our oceans, and be healthier than most of us adults. Honestly, things are changing really, really rapidly, whether it is the oceans, whether it is mental health, the social pressures. Suddenly, it seems to be a tougher life. So it is so much more important that we have conversations, we talk to each other. Everybody is now so much more connected with social media, with the internet, that I think it should be easier for all of us to safeguard ourselves and safeguard our mental health illness. So my suggestion would be talk about it more.
And I'd love to invite you to Lakshadweep to come and swim with us in the
Kadmat
Bangaram. And you tell us when, and we take you all the way to Lakshadweep.
I will be
welcome
there.
Welcome to Lakshadweep,
sure.
Pariniti.
Thank you so much. I will be there. Thank you.
We'll take one more question. Anybody?
Yes, for sure.
Hi, Pariniti.
Hi.
Big fan, first of all.
Thank you so much.
So my question, as an ambassador, you've gone out on many dives. What about the accessibility? Have you ever noticed anything about accessibility? Because I am someone that does dive. We're training to be divers. And
amazing.
So accessibility is the biggest thing. That's an issue. So what would you have to say about that? And how could you help to make dive sites more accessible?
That's a lovely question. First of all, really proud that you're taking this up. I genuinely believe diving is a sport for everyone. People think it's only for really good swimmers or really athletic people. I want to tell you today, it is for everybody. It is especially for people who might not be that sporty or active. I was that person 5 years ago and I took up diving. Having said this, I have been to a few resorts and diving schools who actually take care a lot of people with differences, people with maybe some sort of disability or any kind of challenge. They take care a lot. I have seen special boats go out, special ways of carrying out equipment. There is a lot of help. There is a lot of safety taken care. But of course, I think, like I said, diving has been there for years, but I think that the world is awakening to it now. So I'm sure in another couple of years, there will be no difference between the aspects or features for you guys, for us, for children, for, you know, senior citizens. Anybody will be able to dive, I think.
That answers in an amazing way, actually very motivational. I'd like to invite Amit Malhotra and Kapil Malhotra, directors for Event Solution, to hand over the trophy to Pariniti Chopra.
I win? What did I win today?
And Ismail from High Rise and John. Can we have everybody applaud? Let that keep going. Your claps are running out of oxygen, I guess. That's the Eric's t-shirt, guys. Clap it out.
Hello.
Before going, just thank you. Thank you so much for coming out here. I think all of us in this room are solely responsible for spreading the word. Let's do it. We all love to dive. Let's make other people also love to dive like us. And thank you so much for having me. And I will be here whenever you call me. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Yes. कैमरा में देखूं?
बोले क्या कहना चाहेंगे आज के सोशल
मीडिया पे? मैं बहुत ज़्यादा खुश हूँ. मैंने जो डाइविंग है मैं पिछले 5 साल से कर रही हूँ, एंड ऐसे एक्सपोज के बारे में और फेस्टिवल्स के बारे में मैं अपने इंस्ट्रक्टर से बहुत सुनती थी. तो मैं बहुत ही खुश हूँ कि आज मुझे इंडिया का एम्बेसडर बनाया गया है, एंड मैं जो मेरा पैशन है मैं लोगों में बांट सकती हूँ और लोगों को उत्साहित कर सकती हूँ कि वो भी डाइविंग लें.
फर्स्ट टाइम किस तरह का एक्सपीरियंस था? फर्स्ट टाइम में जब फर्स्ट टाइम स्कूबा डाइविंग करने गई थी, क्या क्या माइंड में चल रहा था उसमें, नर्वसनेस, एक्साइटमेंट?
मैंने सिर्फ फिल्मों में देखा था और मैंने लोगों से सुना था, बट मैंने कभी भी अपने आप एक्सपीरियंस नहीं किया था. तो जब पहली बार मैं गई और जब मैं बाहर आई तो मैं रो रही थी क्योंकि वो बिल्कुल एक लाइफ चेंजिंग एक्सपीरियंस था मेरे लिए. और वो जिस तरह से आपकी बॉडी के सब सेंसेस एक अलाइन हो जाते हैं, वो जो फीलिंग होती है वो मैं आपको समझा नहीं सकती. किस चीज़ के बारे में? नहीं, मैं तो डाइवर हूँ तो उसमें क्या रिसर्च करूँ. उसकी शूटिंग अभी जल्द शुरू हो जाएगी, उसकी ट्रेनिंग चल रही है ज़ोरों शोरों से, और मैं हर रोज़ 2 घंटे बैडमिंटन खेल रही हूँ, 1 घंटा प्रेप कर रही हूँ, ट्रेनिंग कर रही हूँ. तो और अभी हाल ही में मैंने गर्ल ऑन द ट्रेन ख़त्म करी है. तो 2 ऐसी फिल्में हैं जो आई थिंक मेरी करियर की सबसे इंटरेस्टिंग फिल्म्स हैं, ऐसी फिल्में जो मैंने पहले करी नहीं है. तो आई होप कि ऑडियंस को पसंद आए. बहुत ज़्यादा एक्साइटेड हूँ, एंड आई विश ऑल द बेस्ट.